Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. We are discussing on the module 10 properties of psychrometric properties and the psychrometric processes. And this is the fifth lecture on the psychrometrics. So, we recap from the earlier lecture. So, in the previous lecture, we studied about the psychrometric properties like relative humidity, specific humidity, dew point temperature, dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, and degree of saturation, enthalpy of the air and water vapor mixture. So, all the psychrometric properties we studied, and we studied about the psychrometric chart, so which is the graphical representation of all the psychrometric properties. So, using the psychrometric chart, we can collect information, psychrometric properties from the chart, and we studied about the psychrometric processes like sensible heating, cooling and dehumidification, heating and humidification, chemical dehumidification, and adiabatic mixing of air steam. Now, in the previous lecture, fourth lecture, we solved a few problems. So, here again we continue with the problems. This is the fifth lecture on the psychrometric problem in the psychrometric. So, the topic is the problem in the psychrometric properties and psychrometric processes, and the student will be able to solve problem on the at the end of the lecture. The student will be able to solve problem in the psychrometric properties and psychrometric processes. Example number 11. The following condition applied to an air conditioning system of an industrial process, the outdoor conditions are 30 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 65% relative humidity. Indoor conditions are 25 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Free air circulation is 250 meter cube per minute. Calculate capacity of the cooling coil in tons of refrigeration, capacity of the heating coil in kilowatts, and mass of the water vapor removed per hour. So, the given data. So, outdoor conditions are 30 degree dry bulb temperature and 65% relative humidity. Indoor conditions are 25 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. And the amount of air circulation, volume of air circulation is 250 meter cube per minute. Now, we have to solve using the psychrometric chart. So, the outdoor conditions are 30 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 65% relative humidity. So, the 0.1. So, 0.1 is outdoor condition, 30 degree dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity, 65. So, this is 60 and 70, in between 65% relative humidity. Then, indoor conditions, the required conditions, indoor conditions are 25% dry bulb temperature. So, the 0.4, 25% dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. So, this is the outdoor condition available, this is the indoor condition required. So, the process is, this is reducing the temperature and decreasing the water vapor, cooling and dehumidification. So, how this is achieved? So, we go to the cooling process. So, first there will be a cooler, sensible cooler. So, to reduce the temperature to the saturation temperature, once the air reaches the saturation temperature, when you further cool, there will be dehumidification, that is amount of water vapor will be removed, and once you reach this condition, so this is occurring in the dehumidifier, and then once you have the sufficient water temperature, then we again heat it for the to achieve the indoor condition, required indoor condition. So, the first cooling process, cooling coil, second dehumidification process, your dehumidifier, and then third a heating process. Now, we have to collect the properties from the psychrometric chart, like, so this is the initial condition, this is the final condition, this is achieved by the line. So, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. So, 1 to 2 is cooling, 2 to 3 is dehumidification, and 3 to 4 is heating. And the properties, H1 equal to, so we can read H1 equal to 77.2 kilojoules per kilogram, H2 equal to, here, H2 equal to 69 kilojoules per kilogram, H3 equal to 49 kilojoules per kilogram, and it's H4 equal to 58 kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific humidity W1 equal to W2 equal to 18 grams per kilogram of air, and W3 equal to W4 equal to 12.5 grams per kg of air and specific volume of the air at the inlet condition. So, at point 1, the specific volume of the air equal to 0.885 meter cube per kilogram. So, these are all the properties we have to collect from the cyclometric chart. And the mass of the air equal to volume by specific volume. So, V by small v, that is equal to 250 meter cube per minute divided by 60, that gives in second, divided by the specific volume 0.885. So, the mass of the air equal to 4.71 kilograms per second. And capacity heating coil, Ma into H4 minus H1. So, H4 is the enthalpy after heating, H3 is the enthalpy before heating in the heating coil. So, capacity heating coil equal to Ma into H4 minus H3. So, 4.71 into 58 minus 49 equal to 42.39 kilowatts, which is 12.1 ton of refrigeration. Then, capacity of the cooling coil, so Ma into H2 minus H1 is equal to 4.71 into 77.2 minus 69, so which is 38.622 kilowatts, which is 11 ton of refrigeration. So, the capacity of the heating coil is 42.39 kilowatts and capacity of the cooling coil is 38.622 kilowatts. So, this is converted into in ton of refrigeration. The conversion factor is 1 ton of refrigeration is equal to 3.5 kilojoules per second or 3.5 kilowatt. So, 42.39 divided by 3.5 equal to 12.1 tons of refrigeration and 38.622 divided by 3.5 equal to 11 tons of refrigeration. Then the mass of water vapor removed, Ma into W2 minus W3. So, 4.71 into 18.12.5 divided by 1000. So, this 1000 is to convert the grams into kilogram. So, that becomes 0.0259 kilograms per second or 93.24 kilograms per hour of water vapor is removed. And these are all the answers. So, the question is, so recall, so capacity cooling coil in tons of refrigeration, capacity heating coil in kilowatts, mass of the water vapor removed. We have to use the cyclometric chart. So, carefully you locate the point for the indoor and outdoor conditions. You draw the process line. So, cooling line, dehumidification. Dehumidification takes place at the saturation temperature and then heating. Then read the values carefully and calculate the required design parameters. Then, an office to be air conditioned for 50 star when the outdoor conditions are 30 degrees Celsius and 75% relative humidity. If the quantity of air supplied is 0.4 meter cube per minute per person, find the following. 1. Capacity of the cooling coil in tons of refrigeration. Capacity heating coil in kilowatts. Amount of water vapor removed per hour. Assume that the required inlet conditions are 20 degree dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Air is conditioned first by cooling, then dehumidifying and then by heating. And 4, if the heating coil surface temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, find the bypass factor of the heating coil. So, the indoor condition, outdoor conditions, given data, outdoor conditions 30 degrees Celsius and 75% relative humidity. Indoor condition is 20 degrees Celsius and 20 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. The heating coil surface temperature is 25 degree, volume of the air 0.4 meter cube per minute per person, and number of persons equal to 50. And we refer the cyclometric chart. So, the outdoor conditions 30 degree Celsius, 75% relative humidity. So, 30 degree Celsius, 75% relative humidity, this is the 0.1. And the indoor conditions 20 degree Celsius and 60% relative humidity. So, 20 degree Celsius, 60% relative humidity, this is 4. 4 is the required indoor condition. So, the process and the heating coil surface temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. So, 25 degrees, this is 5, which is heating coil surface temperature. The process is achieved first by cooling. 1 to 2 is cooling, 2 to 3 is dehumidification and 3 to 4 is heating. So, cooling, dehumidification and then heating. So, in the cyclometric chart, here in the y-axis, we have the specific humidity, x-axis, we have the dry bulb temperature, and we have different lines. So, these lines are specific volume 0.88, 0.9, 0.9, so specific volume of air. And here, the line, this inclined line are wet bulb temperature and the enthalpy. For enthalpy and the wet bulb temperature, we have the same line. And for others, the curved lines are relative humidity lines. So, 4 One is 30 degree Celsius, 75% relative humidity, and four is 20 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity, and this is 25 degree Celsius surface temperature. So these are all the points. Now we read H1 equal to 84 kilojoules per kilogram, H2 equal to 78 kilojoules per kilogram, H3 equal to 37 kilojoules per kilogram, H4 equal to 44 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific volume of the air at inlet condition. So, one specific volume is 0.89 meter cube per kilogram, and the specific humidity W1 equal to W2. Horizontally, you read specific humidity W1 equal to W2 equal to 20.5 grams per kg, W3 equal to W4 equal to 9 grams per kg. So, these are all the data what is required from the psychrometric chart. Then we calculate mass of the air equal to volume by specific volume, capital V divided by small v, which is 0.4 into 50. So, 0.4 meter cube per minute per person. So, 50 is number of person divided by 60 to convert minutes into second. So, 0.4 into number of person divided by the 60, that gives in meter cube per second. So, divided by the specific volume, the mass of the air will be 0.37 kilograms per second. Now, the capacity of the heating coil, so Ma into H4 minus H3, which is 0.37 into 44 minus 37 equal to 2.59 kilowatt, and capacity of the cooling coil, Ma into H1 minus H2 is equal to 0.37 into 84 minus 78, which is 2.22 kilowatts, and the amount of water vapor removed, Ma into W2 minus W3 equal to 0.37 into 20.5 minus 9 divided by 1000, which is 0.004225 kilograms per second. And bypass factor. So, bypass factor, actually surface temperature of the heating coil minus the outlet temperature of the heating coil, hot air, divided by surface temperature minus the inlet temperature of the hot air. So, in the heating process, so the bypass factor equal to surface temperature minus outlet temperature divided by surface temperature minus inlet temperature. So, 25 minus 20 divided by 25 minus 20 equal to 0.38. So, bypass factor for the heating coil is 0.38. So, these are all the answers for the problem. And example number 13, an air conditioned system is designed for the data. Outdoor conditions are 30 degrees Celsius and 80% relative humidity. Indoor conditions are 22 degrees Celsius and 70% relative humidity. Amount of air circulated is 3.5 meter cube per second. Coil dew point temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. The required condition achieved first by cooling, dehumidification, and then by heating. Determine 1. Capacity of the cooling coil, 2. Capacity of the heating coil, and 3. The amount of water vapor removed. So, again the problem data given. The outdoor conditions are 30 degrees Celsius, 80% relative humidity. Indoor conditions required are 22 degrees Celsius and 70% relative humidity. Amount of air circulated is 3.5 meter cube per second, and the coil dew point temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. So, this is the indoor condition, outdoor condition. Outdoor condition 30 degrees Celsius, 80% relative humidity. So, 30 degrees Celsius, 80% relative humidity. This is the point number 1. Indoor condition 22 degrees Celsius and 70% relative humidity. So, this is 22 degrees Celsius and 22 degrees Celsius, 70% relative, 75% relative humidity, and then coil dew point temperature is T4. This temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. So, this is achieved first by the required condition cooling, dehumidification, and then by heating. So, cooling and dehumidification, this is the process cooling and dehumidification, and then by heating. So, from the cycle, so 1, 2, 3 is the cooling and dehumidification, and 4 is the apparatus dew point temperature. So, before that we are stopping and then we are heating to the required condition. So, from the psychrometric chart, H1 equal to 88 kilojoules per kilogram, H2 here it is 56 kilojoules per kilogram, H3 equal to 52 kilojoules per kilogram, and H4 equal to 41 kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific humidity W1 equal to 0.022 grams per kilogram, W3 equal to W2 equal to 0.013 grams per சாரி கேஜி பெர் கிலோகிராம் அண்ட் டபிள்யூ ஃபோர் ஈக்குவல் டு 0.011 கேஜி பர் கேஜி ஆஃப் ட்ரை ஏர் அண்ட் ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் வால்யூம் அட் தி இன்லெட் கண்டிஷன் 0.892 மீட்டர் கியூப் பர் கிலோகிராம் நவ் யூ கால்குலேட் மாஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஏர் ஸோ மாஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஏர் ஈக்குவல் டு வால்யூம் பை ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் வால்யூம் விச் இஸ் கேபிட்டல் வி பை ஸ்மால் வி விச் இஸ் 3.5 டிவைட் பை 0.892 விச் இஸ் 3.92 கிலோகிராம்ஸ் பர் செகண்ட் ஸோ கெப்பாசிட்டி ஆஃப் தி ஹீட்டிங் காயில் So, MA into H2 minus H1. So, for heating coil, the enthalpy change is H3 minus H2 multiplying by the mass of the air that give the capacity of the heating coil. So, 3.92 into 56 minus 52 equal to 15.68 kilowatts. And capacity of the cooling coil, MA into H1 minus H3. That is mass of the air into enthalpy change across the cooling coil, H3 minus H1, which is 3.92 into 88 minus 52 equal to 141.12 kilowatts. And the amount of water vapor removed this is equal to MA into W1 minus W3 equal to 3.92 into 0.022 minus 0.013 equal to 0.0353 kilograms per second. So, these are all the answers to the problem. Example number 14. A hall is to be air conditioned for the following data. The outdoor conditions are 35 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature. 18 degree Celsius wet bulb temperature. The required comfort conditions are 20 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. The seating capacity of the hall is 2000. The amount of outside air supplied is 0.35 meter cube per minute per person. If the required condition is to be achieved by adiabatic humidification and then by cooling, so first adiabatic dehumidification and then by cooling, determine capacity of the cooling coil and capacity of the humidifier. So, after reading the problem, you write down the given data. Outdoor condition is 35 degrees Celsius, 18 degree dry bulb temperature and 18 degree wet bulb temperature. The required indoor conditions are 20 degree dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Seating capacity is 2000 and amount of outside air supplied is 0.35 meter cube per minute per person. And this is the psychrometric chart. So, the you write down the indoor condition and the outdoor conditions here. So, the process is adiabatic humidification and then cooling. So, 1 to 2 is the adiabatic humidification and 2 to 3 is the cooling process. So, how to draw the line here? So, we are given outdoor conditions 35 degrees Celsius and dry bulb temperature and 18 degree wet bulb temperature. So, 35 degrees Celsius, 35 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, you draw the vertical line and then you draw the inclined line 18 degree wet bulb temperature. So, here it is 18 degree wet bulb temperature. So, these two you draw a line through this. So, it is the process. So, how to get the point 1? 35 degree Celsius from here, 18 degree Celsius from here, this is the point 1. And the adiabatic humidification process, it is going along the line 1 to 2. So, it goes up to a particular condition. How to get the point 2? So, before getting the point 2, you locate point 3. So, point 3 is 20% dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Locate the point 3. Now, draw one horizontal line. Draw one horizontal line because it is heating process. Cooling process. So, draw the horizontal line. This horizontal line will meet the incline line at point 2. So, already we have the incline line. Now, we have the point 3. So, from point 3, you draw one horizontal line. So, this horizontal line and this incline line will meet the point 2. So, 1, 2 and then 3. So, 1 to 2 is adiabatic humidification and 2 to 3 is cooling process. So, once you have the points 1, 2, 3, then you take the enthalpy properties. H1 equal to H2 equal to 52, H3 equal to 43 kilojoules per kilogram, W1 equal to 0.006 kilogram per kg of dry air and W2 equal to W3 equal to 0.0088 and specific volume V1 equal to 0.882. meter cube per kilogram. Then the mass of the air, volume divided by specific volume, 2000 meter cube per minute per person. So, the 0.35 meter cube per minute per person. So, we have 2000 people inside the hall. So, 2000 into 0.35 divided by 60 into 0.882, which is 13.23 kilograms per second. And capacity of the heating cooling coil, M into enthalpy change in the cooling coil, H2 minus H3. This is capacity of the cooling coil is equal to MA into H2 minus H3, which is 13.23 into 51 minus 43 equal to 105.84 kilowatts. And mass of the water vapor removed, MA into W2 minus W3 equal to 13.23 into 0.0088 minus 0.006 equal to 0.037 kilograms per second. So, these two are the answers to the problem. Then we take example number 15. A restaurant is to be air conditioned for winter condition for 100% with the following data. Outdoor conditions are 10 degrees Celsius day bulb temperature, 8 degrees Celsius wet bulb temperature. The required indoor conditions are 20 degrees Celsius day bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. The amount of air supplied is 0.35 meter cube per minute per person. The required conditions to be achieved first by heating, then adiabatic dehumidifying. Adiabatic humidifying. First by heating, then adiabatic humidifying. Calculate heating capacity of the coil and the capacity of the humidifier. So, write down the data. Outdoor condition 10 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, 8 degrees Celsius wet bulb temperature. Required indoor conditions are 20 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Amount of air supplied equal to 0.35 meter cube per minute per person and number of persons are 100. So, this is outdoor condition 10 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, 8 degrees Celsius wet bulb temperature. You have to locate the one for 10 degree dry bulb temperature and 8 degree wet bulb temperature. Then first process heating and then the next process required indoor conditions 20 degree Celsius day bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. So this is 20 degree Celsius, 60% relative humidity. So how to draw the line? So look at the process. First heating, then adiabatic humidifying. So 0.1, you locate 0.1. So, 0.1 is 10 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature, 8 degree wet bulb temperature. So, this is 0.1. First heating, you draw the horizontal line for heating process. You draw the horizontal line. Now, you locate the indoor condition. So, this is 20 degree Celsius and 60% relative humidity, 0.2. Now, from 0.2, along the line, along this line. So, we have this point. So, there is one incline line. Along the incline line that indicates the heating and humidification. Adiabatic heating. So, this is called as adiabatic heating process. So, draw one incline line. So, this incline line will meet the horizontal line at the 0.3. So, how we achieve? So, 1 to 3 heating and 3 to 2, it is what called as adiabatic humidification. Now, you read the properties. H1 equal to 28.5 kilojoules per kilogram. H2 equal to H3 equal to 48.3 kilojoules per kilogram. W1 equal to W3 equal to 0.058 kilograms per kg of air. And W2 equal to 0.0085 kg per kg of air. And specific volume of the air at the inlet condition, V1 equal to 0.81 meter cube per kilogram. So, all these values you have to read from the psychrometric chart. And mass of the air, so MA equal to volume by specific volume, which is volume divided by specific volume, V by capital V by small v, 100%, 0.35 meter cube per minute per person, so divide by 60 to convert into second, into specific volume 0.81, so the amount of air is 0.72 kg per kg kilograms per second, and capacity of the heating coil, MA into H2 minus H1, so heating enthalpy change in the heating coil, H2 minus H1, into mass of the air, so 0.72 into 48.3 minus 28.5 equal to 14.256 kilowatts, and the capacity humidifier that is equal to mass of the water vapor removed, which is MA into W2 minus W1, which is 0.72 into 0.0085 minus 0.0058 equal to 0.00194 kilograms per second. So, these two are the answers to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID. You please subscribe the channel so that I will give all the updated video for the subject. There are many more videos available in this YouTube channel on thermal engineering subjects. You can listen to all the lectures for your learning. So, thank you for watching. We'll meet again.